if the last class we discussed about stages of the engineering surveys. What are the stages of engineering surveys? First one, map study. Second one, reconnaissance. Third one, preliminary surveys. And fourth one, final location and detailed surveys. Today we are take first one, map study. What is map study in the engineering survey? Briefly, it is very simple. Map study means we are going to study the topographical map for choosing proper alignment for highway construction, choosing proper alignment. What type of map we are going to study? Topographical map. Let us see what is map study in detail. If the topographic map of the area is available, it is possible to suggest the likely routes of the road. In India, topographic maps are available from the Survey of India. The Survey of India is the department. With 15 or 30 meter contour intervals, this is the 15 or 30 meter contour interval. This is the standard contour interval map is available in Survey of India. The main features like rivers, hills, valleys, etc. are also shown on these maps. By careful study of such maps, it is possible to have an idea of several possible alternate routes, so that further details of these may be studied later at the site. The probable alignment can be located on the map from the following details available on the map. First one, alignment avoiding valleys, ponds or lakes. See, it is very important. These are the details available by studying the topographical map. In the time of studying the map, we are keeping this point in mind. First one, alignment avoiding valleys, ponds or lakes. Second one, when the road has to cross a row of hills, possibility of crossing through a mountain pass. Approximate location of bridge, site for crossing rivers, avoiding bend of the river, if any. See, it is also very important. Approximate location of bridge site for crossing rivers, avoiding bend of the river, if any. We should avoid the bridge construction on highway alignment in the place of river bend. Okay. Next, when a road is to be connected between two stations, one of the top and the other on the foot of the hill, then alternate routes can be suggested, keeping in view the permissible gradient. Say the rolling gradient, we also call permissible gradient or rolling gradient. Suppose the scale of the contour map is known, then from the contour intervals it is possible to decide the length of the road required between two consecutive contours. I hope you know the meaning of contour line. You already studied this contour line and all in the survey first, but once again I will recall you. What is contour line means? Contour line is the imaginary line on the earth's surface for representing elevation, known elevation on the earth's surface. Keeping the gradient within allowable limits, in this case the contour interval is 15 meter, and if the ruling gradient is fixed as 1 in 20, the road length between two consecutive contours has to be 15 multiplied by 20 is equal to 300 meter. How we are going to calculate the road length? 15 is the contour interval distance and 20 is the gradient, 1 in 20. The gradient is 20, so the road length is 300 meters. With the known scale of the map, the various possible alternate routes may be drawn by drawing arcs of the above, that means 300 meter length between the consecutive contour lines. For easy understanding, you can refer this figure. Let A and B two stations to be connected by a road. AB is the shortest route. AB is the, you can observe the figure, AB is the shortest route. AB is the shortest route, straight line. APQB is the steep route in which the gradient positively exceeds 1 in 20. Okay, see here you can observe the figure carefully. This is the alignment with allowable gradient. These lines are the contour lines. See, observe. This is the 150, 165, 195. That means this is hill. It is correct, no? It is the hill because it is increasing. Observe, 150 meter contour, 165 meter contour line, 195 meter contour line. These are the contour lines. You can observe here, contour line or irregular shape, but it is closed line. It will goes like this, but at one point it will meet to again to this line. Okay, it is very clear. It is the continuously this line wherever goes. No, these all points are 150 meter elevation point. 150 meter elevation point connecting continuous line it is. Okay, now come to this. The AB is the shortest route. You can observe AB is the shortest route, and APQB is the steeper gradient, and APLMNB is the flatter gradient. Flatter gradient. See, like this, the route, how you can observe APLMNB. This is the flatter gradient. Next, alternate routes. This is also next. APEFGB. This is flat. This is also flatter gradient, but it is alternate route for this route. Alternate route for this route. That means APLMNB. Okay. This is the alignment with allowable gradient. Okay, thank you.